Hi, assalamu alaikum. Today I would like to talk about I would like to tell you a story. It takes place in a small pasture in an English country where everyone could bring their cattle for grazing. The land does not belong to anyone particular, so you are most welcome to bring all of your cattle for grazing. Over time, more and more farmers bring in their cattle for grazing, as they can do this without having to take care of the land themselves. However, as more cattle are being brought in for grazing, the land becomes less and less able to support the grazing. And since the cattle are always grazing, the grass eaten doesn't get any chance to grow back. And eventually, the pasture becomes bare and unusable. Now, this bountiful resource that was once available for all of us is now depleted and can no longer be used by anyone. So, this scenario is called the Tragedy of the Commons. Tragedy of the Commons was published by Garrett Hardin, a well-known biologist, in 1968. Where the theory states that every individual who acts rationally and independently according to their own self-interest will deplete a shared resource even if it is contrary to a group. Individual farmers that I told in the story was acting rationally and independently for themselves. Because for them, it was beneficial to bring as many cattle as they can and to feed them. Since it is free, right? Because each individual acted this way and not just one of them, the group suffered as a whole. Because the pasture become less and less usable, which makes it unusable, as the shared resource was depleted. Actually, Hardin's essay regarding this very story, The Tragedy of the Commons, which was published by an economist named William Foster Lloyd back in 1833. Hardin took this idea and ran with it. And he felt that this problem is faced in many social aspects because each individual gains a direct benefit from exploiting a common resource while only experiencing a minimal cost. Let me give you a few examples. The Tragedy of the Commons is often brought up to people when they are discussing about environmental issues. For example, in fishing, if fishing, provides income for someone, it would be best option in mind to catch as many fishes as you can. But if all of these fishers think of the same thing to catch as many fishes as they can, this behavior, if it continues, the shared resource, which is the fish, will no longer be available for them and will eventually deplete. So, the result is the group will suffer as a whole. This is relatable to what I told you from before. Another example is, often this tragedy is cited in deforestation. Deforestation of rainforests means you need to clear cut the trees, right? So while clear cutting the trees, there's a lot of reasons for you to cut trees. One of them is maybe for pasture grazing, for development, and etc. So when you clear cut trees, it may directly benefit those who own and use the land. That's not something we could argue on, because that is basically what they'll get, the benefit from cutting down trees, right? What they don't see is if one continues to do this, The cost of losing the rainforest land is more widely distributed. So that's what they don't see. And this is the same for pollution as well, where people prefer to go to work by car instead of doing carpooling or using the public transport. So imagine each and one of us decides to go to work using our own cars, where these cars emit greenhouse gases. But because the air is common to everyone, since we all share the same air, right? The overall public has to deal with that pollution that each person contributes. It's just a simple analogy. Because of one person, and this one person behaves rationally and independently because of themselves, this group will suffer just because of this individual's doing. Simple, right? So, what did Hardin said about this, and how do we overcome this? Well, by limiting the use of local farmers and herders, managing use through practices such as crop rotation and seasonal grazing, and providing enforceable sanctions against the overuse of resource. And also, according to Investopedia, one possible solution to tragedy of the commons is top-down government regulation or direct control of a common pool resource. This can reduce overconsumption and government investment in conservation and renewal of the resource. Or you can also convert a common pool resource into a private good. Well, there are actually more ways on how we could reduce the effect of the tragedy of the commons, as what Hardin wrote in his paper. But I guess that is all for now. Thank you for watching. I hope this video has been beneficial for you. And thank you for listening. Take care. Assalamualaikum.